Hey, it's Joe again. As you know, I use a Pixel 2 XL, and one of the main reasons why I use a Pixel is because of Project Fi. And if you don't know about Project Fi, what it is it's Google's answer to the service providers such as T-Mobile, Verizon, AT&T, etc. It's useful in certain cases and for certain people. Now for me, I have Wi-Fi here at my shop and also at home. So if you're like me and you have Wi-Fi at home and also where you work, meaning you don't use very much data at the end of the month, this might be something that you might want to look into if you have a Google phone. So I used to have AT&T and I had really good reception everywhere I went, except for places where there were large crowds of people. I guess a lot of people have AT&T. So the way that it works is it switches between three different carriers. If I'm in a place where I'm using Wi-Fi, if I'm in a phone call, it won't drop that phone call when I leave. So it'll automatically switch to Sprint, T-Mobile, or US Cellular, whichever one has the best signal. So let's get to the price. It's extremely low. It's $20 for the first plan and $15 for each additional person that you add to it. Now, they also charge you $10 per gig, but only up to 10 gigabytes. After that, it's unlimited, but it throttles at 15 gigabytes. So again, it's not for the person who uses a ton of data. It's not for you. But if you find that you use less than 3 gigabytes or 2 gigabytes, it might be a way to save money. For example, before my wife and I, our plan used to be somewhere around, and now our plans are somewhere close to around. I'm kind of curious, let me know what plan you have and how much it costs you per month. So also, if you like to travel and if you go to different countries, you know how it is. You're always worried like, oh, how much is this gonna actually cost me? With Project Fi, you only get charged for the data that you use. And that's at the same rate that you normally get charged. So if you don't go over your data, then you don't get charged anything extra. If you're gonna be traveling, you might wanna take a look at their website and see which countries they cover. Let me explain how the pricing works. So you set in advance how much you think you're gonna use. So let's say you think you're gonna use about 2 gigs, right? If you go over that, say you use 3 gigs, then you get charged 10 bucks. If you go under that and you only use 1 gig, for example, then they refund that back to your account. I also like feeling like I own my number, and that's the way I feel when I use Project Fi, or prior to this, it was Google Voice. So I can easily transfer my phone number around and it's not a hassle, you know what I mean? Project Fi also supports eSIM, and that's the electronic SIM. When I got my Pixel 2 XL, I didn't have to put in a SIM card. I just had to activate it and it was working, so that was pretty cool. Let's talk about the customer support. So I've always been able to contact somebody at customer support really quickly. I opened up the chat on my app. I was able to contact somebody right away. They talked to me, boom, solved the problem, real easy. If you want, you can have them call you so you don't have to wait on the line. It's pretty cool. And their website is fast, right? If I wanna go and take a look at some information, see my bill, all that, change something, it's super fast. I don't know what's going on with these other, AT&T, what's going on, man? You guys have, billions of dollars? T-Mobile, same thing, you guys have a lot of money. Why is your website so slow? I kind of get the feeling that they make it that way so that you can't change up your account and change your plan and try to save money. Conspiracy theory. Let me talk about my favorite thing about Project Fi, and that's the data-only SIM. So as of right now, they'll allow you to have up to 5 data-only SIMs, meaning you can't use them for voice or text. So I have a bunch of old devices lying around. I have old phones, tablets, and I was able to pop in one of these data-only SIMs. And now this device has new life. I can take it around anywhere. I can use the internet on it. I gave it to my 1-year-old and she's able to do whatever she wants. So that's pretty cool. My grandparents are another example of why the data only SIM is super useful. So they live in a different state. We pay for a phone plan for them to be able to answer the front door, right? So in order to buzz people in basically. We're paying monthly for a phone specifically for that purpose. So I thought to myself, we could save some money just by getting them an inexpensive phone. We ended up getting them a Nextbit Robin, which was pretty cool. We popped in a data-only SIM. I set them up with a brand new Google Voice number, all free, and we installed Hangouts. So that way they could receive phone calls and text using the Hangouts app. So that was pretty cool. Now they can actually use that phone to receive phone calls, receive texts. They can take it anywhere with them, and it actually acts as a normal phone. All it does is use the data. We cut that whole bill we don't have to pay for a separate phone number for them. I don't know, I think it's pretty awesome. So a few cons: it needs a Nexus 5X, a 6P, any of the Pixel phones, or a Motorola X4. But I've tried it on an iPhone and it still works for calls. I was able to get a 4G signal, but texts don't really work as far as MMS. It was kind of giving me some issues with that. Another thing it doesn't do is it doesn't switch carriers. It only stays on the T-Mobile network. Also, you can't use Wi-Fi calling. So yeah, basically, I think Project Fi is really something that Google needs to really start pushing hard now. I think for a lot of people who don't use a lot of data, it's one of the main reasons why you should get a Pixel phone. I really love it. I love saving money and my service is great. So if you're interested, I'm gonna leave a link to my affiliate code. You'll get $20 Fi credit and I get a little something too. Win-win, right? So anyways, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it useful. If you did, like and subscribe. Take care. Bye-bye.